Perhaps you have already stumbled upon pictures of horned hares. The image of a chimera, in various versions, is found in the mythologies of many countries. American jackalope, Swedish svarda, or German wolpertinger. The human brain is capable of making up many marvels, but in this case, people indeed saw horned hares. And the culprit of such mind tricks was a virus. When in the early 30s, taxidermists from Wyoming made a stuffed hare and add horns to it, they created a beautiful legend about horned rabbits living in the district. And the local authorities were only happy because this stimulated the influx of tourists. They even started issuing permits to hunt jackalopes.
Zoinks! A jackalope? I thought those things were fake!
When the news reached Richard Shope, a scientist at Rockefeller University, he asked his friend to catch one such rabbit and send him the pieces of its horns. His colleague Francis Peyton Roux, experimenting with chickens, suggested that certain types of viruses could cause tumors. Many scientists were skeptical of this statement, but Shope wondered if the horns could be tumors caused by an unknown virus. To verify this, Shope ground the horns, made a solution, and filtered the resulting liquid through porcelain clay. Only viruses could penetrate through the pores in the clay. Then, Shope rubbed the filtered solution into the heads of healthy rabbits. Horns grew on their heads. And if you're interested in how mythological creatures look in reality, then here it is. Indeed, to see it for real is not a pretty sight, and here I must warn you that following images may be more shocking. Later, people began to notice that such growths can occur in all mammals. Those behind the screen, get ready. It can be cows, humans' best friends, dogs, even giraffes, and many others. And since mammals were under threat, humans also fell into this list. The most famous story happened in the 80s in Indonesia with a boy named Dede Koswara. Being a teenager, he began to develop warts, which eventually completely covered the skin on his arms and legs. The growths clung to his limbs so much that he could no longer work. People called him Tree Man. Reports about Dede were leaked to the media, and in 2007, doctors removed more than 5 kilograms of warts from his body. But unfortunately, he had to continue to have newly appearing warts surgically removed. Moreover, with age, tumors reappeared faster. By 36 years, tumors grew at a rate of 5 millimeters per month. As it turns out, the growths on Dede's body and other humans and mammals were caused by the same virus, the very same that caused rabbits to grow horns. It was called Papillomavirus, from the Latin papilla, a nipple-like. Dede's life was tragic. His wife and 2 children left him when his hands became so entangled with growths that he could no longer work. In order to support his children, he was forced to join the wandering performance crew, who demonstrated their skin mutations to the onlookers. People call it a freak show. "I'm just trying to be a good father, but I can't give them everything they need. I'm sad that I can't touch them." And if you wonder why there are no human trees walking around that are similar to mythological Ents, the answer is that Dede was just out of luck. The human papillomavirus, abbreviated HPV, is not a rare thing. In fact, it is rather ordinary. Approximately 79 million Americans are infected with HPV, and another 14 million become infected each year. Usually, the human immune system is in balance with the virus and no serious consequences occur. Maybe a couple of warts might pop up on the skin and mucous tissues. But Dede inherited a genetic defect in the immune system. Due to the lack of white blood cells, his body simply was not able to fight the virus. It can be said that HPV seized his skin cells, causing them to produce keratin in enormous quantities. Keratin is the protein that makes up our hair and nails. And of course, the socioeconomic factor played its part. Dede was a resident of a small village in Indonesia. An accidental cut, papillomavirus, a genetic defect, poverty, and a low level of medicine, all this combined derailed the life of an Indonesian boy who dreamed of becoming a joiner and turned him into a human tree. Dede Koswara passed away on January 30th, 2016, at the age of 45. Unfortunately, such growths are not the worst thing that HPV can cause. In some cases, it leads to cancer. That medical discovery was made thanks to the horned rabbits. When Shope's colleague Francis Roux injected liquid from infected growths into the bodies of rabbits, he found that the horns didn't grow. Instead, rabbits developed cancer that they could not survive. For his research and finding a link between cancer and the virus, Roux received the Nobel Prize in Medicine in 1966. In 1970, his idea was picked up by German researcher Harald von Hausen. For several years, he tried to find the DNA genes of viruses in cancerous tumors, and in 1983, he discovered the DNA of the papillomavirus. Since then, people have discovered hundreds of HPV strains, 16 of which are high oncogenic risk viruses, meaning they can cause cancer with a high probability. The most common ones are numbered 16 and 18, and they are responsible for 70% of cervical cancer. The vaccines recommended by World Health Organization are aimed precisely at these types. While, for example, strains 6 and 11 are more specialized in warts in the anogenital zone and airways, there are also harmless strains. So, 79 million Americans are infected, but no one sounds the alarm and no people turn into trees. Although you can't say that the virus is absolutely safe. After all, every year around 19,000 women and 12,000 men get cancer due to HPV, and we are only talking about America. Infection begins when a virus injects its DNA into a host cell. HPV specializes in infecting epithelial cells, which make up most of the skin and mucous membranes. Eventually, virus genes enter the cell nucleus, which contains the cell's own genes. Next, the virus causes the cell to divide. The more infected cells, the more viruses. Cellular division is a very complex mechanism, involving 23 pairs of chromosomes, more than 3 billion DNA letters, which form 20,000 human genes. This whole process could be controlled by the papillomavirus, which itself contains 8 genes, 2 of which are responsible for its protein cover, a suit protecting the virus from its environment, also known as capsid. Moreover, the size of the virus is 30 nanometers. It is 10,000 times less than the thickness of a needle. It is suggested that the roots of the papillomavirus go back 200,000 years, which means humans have been its carriers for a long time. Over time, the virus evolved and its new types appeared. Perhaps some strains are already inside you and you haven't even felt them, and you won't. Perhaps your friend has a couple of warts on their body due to papillomavirus. These cases aren't that worrying, but some people may be less fortunate. World Health Organization provides certain recommendations for cancer prevention, which can be summed up as follows. Get vaccinated when you are 9 to 14 years old, don't smoke, protect your immune system, have sex in a condom. Any sexually active person can become infected with HPV, even if they have sex with only one partner. Therefore, safety is everything. In most cases, HPV goes away by itself and does not cause any health problems. But when it doesn't, it can lead to nasty things like genital warts and cancer. Or maybe it won't. If a person has a strain with medium or high oncogenic risk, careful attention and observation by a doctor are required. That's it for the story of horned rabbits who told people about the human papillomavirus. And I'm Bonyright.